सीरीज फॉर बीटेक शिक्षक सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस। माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। टुडेज टॉपिक इज रिलेटेड टू इवेल्यूएटिंग एंड चूजिंग द बेस्ट हाइपोथेसिस, एंड फॉर दिस वी स्टडी अबाउट मॉडल सिलेक्शन। सो स्टार्ट विथ इवेल्यूएटिंग एंड चूजिंग द बेस्ट हाइपोथेसिस। सो actually we want to learn a hypothesis that fits the future data best, and to make that precise we need to define future data and best, and we make the stationary assumption that there is a probability distribution over examples that remains satisfactory or stationary over time, and each example data point is a random variable ej whose observed value ej is equal to xj yj is sampled from that distribution and is independent of the previous example. So here is probability ej given to ej minus 1 then comma ej minus 2 to so on, and is equal to probability of ej, and each example has an identical prior probability distribution. So probability of ej is equal to probability of ej minus 1 is equal to probability of ej minus 2 and so on. So example that satisfy these assumptions are called independent and identically distributed, or iid assumptions. So iid assumptions connect the past to the future. Without some such connections, all bets are off and the future could be anything. And next step is to define best fit. So we define the error rate of a hypothesis as the proportion of mistakes it makes and the proportion of times that hx is not equal to y for n xy example. And now because a hypothesis h has a low error rate on the training set, does not mean that it will generalize well, and a professor knows that an exam will not accurately evaluate students if they have already seen the exam question. So similarly, to get an accurate evaluation of a hypothesis, we need to test it on a set of examples it has not seen yet, and the simplest approach is the one we have already seen, and randomly split the available data into a training set from which the learning algorithm produces H and a test set on which the accuracy of H is evaluated. So thus the method, sometimes called holdout cross validation, and has the disadvantage that it fails to use all the available data. If we use half the data for the test set, then we are only training on half the data and we may get a poor hypothesis. On the other hand, if we reserve only 10% of the data for the test set, then we may be statistical chance get a poor estimate of the actual accuracy. So we can squeeze more out of the data and still get an accurate estimate using a technique called k-fold cross validation. So the idea is that each example serves double duty as training data and test data. First we split the data into k equal subsets. We then perform k rounds of the learning. On each round, 1 divided by k of the data is held out as a test set, and the remaining examples are used as training data. The average test score of the k round should be a better estimate than a single score, and popular values for k are 5 or 10, enough to give an estimate that is statistically likely to be accurate at a cost of 5 to 10 times longer computation time. And the example extreme is k is equal to n, also known as leave one out cross validation or LOOCV. So despite the best effort of the statistical methodologies, users frequently invalidate their results by inadvertently picking at the test data. Picking can happen like this: a learning algorithm that various knobs that can be twiddled to tune its behavior. For example, various different criteria for choosing the next attribute in decision tree learning. The researchers generate hypotheses for various different settings of knobs, measures their error rates on the test sets, and reports the error rate of the best hypothesis. Also, picking has occurred. The reason is that the hypothesis was selected on the basis of its test set error rate. So information about the test set has leaked into the learning algorithm. Then picking is a consequences of using test set performance on both choose a hypothesis and evaluate it. The way to avoid this is to really hold the test set out, lock it away until you are completely done with learning and simply wish to obtain an independent evaluation of the final hypothesis. And if the test set is locked away but you still want to measure performance on unseen data as a way of selecting a good hypothesis, then divide the available data into a training set and a validation set. So here we have model selection, complexity versus goodness of fit. So here there is a figure 18.1. So we will go to our figure 1.1. Okay, sorry, here. Okay, this is 18.1. So we already see that higher degree polynomials can fit the training data better than, but when the degree is too high, they will overfit and perform poorly on validation data. Choosing the degree of polynomials is an instance of the problem of model selection, and you can think of the task of finding the best hypothesis. So here, okay, best hypothesis has two tasks, and first is model selection, define the hypothesis space, and then optimization, find the best hypothesis within that space. So start, we have to explain how to select among models that are parameterized by size, or for example, with polynomials we have size equal to 1 for linear function and size equal to 2 for quadratics, and so on. For decision trees, the size could be the number of nodes in the tree, and in all cases we want to find the values of the size parameter that best balances underfitting and overfitting to give the best test set accuracy. So an algorithm to perform model selection and optimization is shown in here, the cross validation wrapper. So, and another cross validation, it is a wrapper that takes a learning algorithm as an argument, for example decision tree learning, and the wrapper enumerates model according to a parameter size. For each size, it uses cross validation on learner to compute the average error rate on the training and test sets. And we start with the smallest, simplest model, and iterate considering more complex model at each step until the model starts to overfit. And here is the figure, another error rates on training data. So we see typical curves here, and the training set error decreases monotonically, and while the validation set error decreases at first, then increases when the model begins to overfit. So the cross validation procedure picks the value of size with the lowest validation set error, the bottom of the U-shaped curve, and we then generate a hypothesis of that size using all the data. And finally, we should evaluate the returned hypothesis on a separate test set. So this approach requires that a learning algorithm accept a parameter size and deliver a hypothesis of that size. And we can say the for decision tree learning, the size can be number of nodes, and we can modify decision tree learner so that it takes the number of nodes as input and builds the tree breadth first rather than depth first. And stops when it reaches the desired number of nodes. So this is all about model selections. So here our session ends. Thank you.